Salvete Discipoli. Here we are at Mission San Jose in South San Antonio. This mission has been here for about 300 years, and today we're listening to the mariachi after the Mass here at the Church of San Jose, St. Joseph. Okay, Chapter 7. Chapter 7, you're finally going to meet the third declension. You've met the first declension and the second declension already. Now it's time to meet the third declension. Important thing, you tell the declension of a noun by its genitive ending. If it's first declension, the genitive is going to end in A-E. If it's second declension, the genitive is going to end in the letter I. If it's third declension, the genitive is going to end in the letters I-S. And you find that in the second word after the first word in your vocabulary list, the purple box in each chapter. Under nouns, the first noun is the nominative form, and from now on, the second form will be the genitive form coming after the nominative form. And it's the genitive form that gives you the declension of the noun. So that's what's important there. You also have third declension adjectives, which mimic the endings of the third declension noun. The only difference being that the ablative singular ends in an I rather than an E. You will also see the use of irregular verbs, possum and ao. Possum is a combination of P-O-T plus S-U-M, I am able. And you'll see the declension for that in the grammar section of chapter 7 in the back of the book, also the index of grammar forms there. Okay, so third declension, chapter 7. You have a noun chart in your files to download. In that noun chart, you see the singular, the plural of the nominative, the genitive, the accusative, and the ablative. We're not going to worry an awful lot about what the genitive case means at this point. We will in another chapter, perhaps chapter 9. Right now, the genitive is just telling us what declension the noun is in, just the same way as the infinitive, the vowel in front of the re of the infinitive, told us what conjugation the verb was in. Okay? So pull those files to download about chapter 7. I hope you're chunking that Latin, taking it piece by piece so that you can understand what each phrase means and then put it together for the whole sentence. This is also a great opportunity for you to study the Trojan War. We're getting right in the midst of Agamemnon and Menelaus, his brother, and Achilles and Ulysses and Hector and Paris, all these Greek heroes and Trojan heroes that are running around having the Trojan War. Maybe you saw the famous movie by Brad Pitt there, or with Brad Pitt, last May. I know my students did at Lee High School. Anyway, enjoy the third declension. You're going to be living with these three declensions for the rest of the block. Valete de Skipley.
Yeah.